This is A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. And today we are going to be talking about evidence for evolution. This is ended up being a longer video, so I broke it up into two different parts. This is part one. So like I said previously, evolution is a theory. That's 100% true, but in science, theory actually carries a lot of weight because theories are well supported with evidence. And there's actually a lot of evidence that supports evolution. In this video, I'm going to be talking about two of these pieces of evidence. Number one and number two. Number one is homologous, analogous, and vestigial structures. And then number two is geographic distribution. I'll be discussing the other three in part two of this video. For the first one though, homologous structures. So this is a really huge piece of evidence that supports the idea, the theory of evolution. So what homologous structures are, they are traits that have the same form, but they perform different functions. So this is really key in evolution that we have these structures that are set up, their orientation, the bones are the same, but because of mutations, they perform different functions. So with this image over here, you have all these different bones that are highlighted in the picture. So each structure has a green bone. That's the humerus. They have radius, the carpals. So these are bone structures. You don't really need to know the names of the bones. But what you do have to understand is that we have a penguin, we have an alligator, we have a human, and we have a bat, and they all have the same bone setup. However, they use their bones in different ways. So they use their structures in different ways. Obviously, you know, whales use them to swim, bats use their appendages to fly, and us humans, we use our four limbs to grab things. So it's the same form, the same bones, but we use them for different functions. This is the opposite to analogous structures. So what analogous structures are is actually the exact opposite of homologous. So it is structures that have a different form. However, these structures serve the same purpose. So we could talk about fish. We can also talk about wings in birds and insects. So with wings, we'll just use wings for an example. You could look at the bat wing, you could look at the bird wing, you could look at the insect wing, and they are all set up. They don't have the same bones. It wasn't like the previous example where they have the exact same bones. However, each of these wings serve the same purpose, which is flying. So analogous structures are things that have a different form, but they serve the same purpose. Okay, vestigial structures, this is the final one for number one, and this is one of the biggest pieces of evidence for evolution that a lot of evolutionary biologists like to cling onto. Vestigial traits and structures, you might have heard of them. They are traits that serves no useful function in an organism, but they're evidence of a common ancestor. So these traits, vestigial traits, are completely useless in modern day species. And we have a lot of vestigial traits in humans. And it really serves no purpose. So the question is, like, why do we have them? The answer to that question is, well, because our common ancestor, the species that came before us, they had these traits, and that's why we have them. So vestigial traits in humans that serve no purpose, the tailbone, we have a tailbone on our spinal cord, and it goes all the way down past our vertebrae, and the bone itself serves no purpose. Goosebumps, you get goosebumps when you get scared or when you get cold. Those serve no purpose. The ability to move your ears, if you can do that, that doesn't serve a purpose either. But our ancestors, our common ancestors, were able to do these things and had these traits, and they had a purpose for them. But now that we have advanced, we no longer have a purpose for them. Whales are another good example. Whales actually have a hind limb bone. It's because they used to be terrestrial. Now they are not. So they still have the bone, although you don't even see hind legs on whales. The second piece that we're going to talk about in this video is geographic distribution. I really like the picture on the right here because what it's trying to show you is that there are species that are all around the world. The species on the right, they all look very similar. The beaver, the muskrat, the capybara, they look very, very similar, but they don't share that much evolutionary history. So they're not really that closely related. However, geographic distribution is evidence for evolution because what it states is if there are similar selection pressures, so if there's similar ecological conditions in an environment, then the organisms are going to look similar. So with these animals on the right, they all have fur coats, they're short, they're to the ground, they have strong teeth. So they all look similar, although they are not that closely related. And you could say the same thing's true for fish, that the environment determines the traits, and as a result, similar environments are going to have similar traits. Like all fish are really smooth. They don't have these lavish fur coats because that would slow them down. The last concept we're going to do here, this is the idea of convergent evolution. Convergent evolution is the process by which unrelated organisms, like the capybara, like the beaver, like the muskrat, unrelated organisms come to resemble one another because of their environment. This has been A Bit of Biology with Mr. Rock. I'm signing off.